clarity from LeeCamp.net. Life is a spark of a flare of a flickering mistake. That's it. It's a galactic accident that you or anyone is here. We are an atomic coincidence. We are a fart in the primordial soup. We are an unexpected surprise fungus on a pebble floating around in nothing and in nowhere. We are the universe's unplanned, unwanted, unintended pregnancy. Don't ask me who knocked up the universe, but talk about doing the big girl. Holy shit. In the scope of things, we are beyond next to nothing. Some people find this realization depressing, but I find it empowering. It means that this is it. Right here, right now. What you're doing today, this hour, this minute, is absolutely, decisively, unconditionally everything. It's all that matters. It's all that can matter. Because the past is gone or relegated to a camera phone, and the future is unknowable, or at the very least, rather shy. How fucking exciting is that? Right now is the shit! You thought it was a boring day on your couch or the day the recycling got picked up. You thought it was a dental appointment or a boob job, a rectal exam or a hand job. But no, it's everything that matters. On the other hand, the religious evangelical view of the whole mess is truly depressing. You're telling me we're in a meaningless waiting room before we head to an even more meaningless waiting room that has better pillows and comfy shoes? And we're in that waiting room for eternity? Jesus, fuck, kill me. If I can find a way to stab myself with a cloud, I'm gonna fucking do it and get the hell out of here. No pun intended. So when you put the two together, that we are nothing, and that of that nothing, this moment is everything, it should change the way we live. It should mean we don't waste our days hoarding money or resources or planning what our individual lives will be like 15 years from now. We're more concerned with helping the guy next to us than catching the bus. We're tasting the wine and the fruit and the ramen noodles. That's right, even the fucking ramen noodles. We're making love to the person rather than to an idea. We aren't nervous about our aging, our looks, our legacy, our text or our tweets, the rash on our taints or the cash in our safes. I mean, what are we saving it for? Retirement? When most of us retire 35 or 55 years from now, Goldman Sachs will have found at least 200 separate ways to steal all the symbolic pieces of paper we've saved. Who are you kidding? Give the greatest criminal minds of our time some fucking credit. Don't disrespect them like that and act like you'll still have your money 5 decades from now. And if you're one of them, one of the ridiculously rich, think about how much time they spend worrying about their money rather than living something resembling a life. The problem is our ego. We think we're so fucking special. A surprising percentage of us even think we've been alien anal probed, as if beings from thousands of light years away really want to know what's up our butts. In reality, we are a speck of mold on a piece of debris floating in the middle of 1,000 oceans. And the weird thing is, if we just realized we're nothing, we could actually live like we really matter. That's your moment of clarity from LeeCamp.net. If you get a chance, leave a comment about a time that you realized what really matters. Also, check out the Moment of Clarity podcast. I'll be discussing some of those comments. I'll also have an exclusive song from the band Doko coming up soon. So check it out, LeeCamp.net. Thanks. No plans at all. Evil man's always transcending. Fight her like sheep, swallow everything. Always simpletons or pretending.